I was diagnosed with anorexia nervosa at age 11. You think of yourself as inadequate or unworthy. Your frame of mind goes to, okay, well, what do I need to do in order to have worth? And so the comparison becomes, okay, well, these guys are being idolized, or this image is being put on the front of magazines, or they're being cast in the roles of, you know, superheroes, or whoever, whatever it is. It starts to build up these beliefs that you have about yourself. So for me, it was the belief that I'm worthless, I don't belong, I'm unlovable. And they formed very young, and they had many years to form and continue to grow, and then I'd behave in correspondence with that. I need to manipulate my body, my hair, I need to change my clothes, I need to change the brand of clothing that I'm wearing. I need to go against the organic nature of my body. The counterintuitive thing that happened was, even though I started to change the way that I looked, I was never satisfied. I think what prompted me to ask for help was this sense of not knowing a way out of what was happening, and this all-encompassing, all-day thinking and obsession over the way that I looked. I needed another perspective on that. And when I started to get that help, my life started to transform for the better. Not instantly, you can't put a time on healing, but when you start to come at those things and greet them face on, it starts to lessen that burden and you start to heal. If we experience physical pain, we're hardwired to pay attention to that physical pain so that we can remove the source of the pain and so that we can heal it. Somewhere along the way, with emotional pain and psychological pain, we've been taught to ignore it, push it down, and get rid of it. But just like physical pain, we need to turn towards it, recognize that it's there, and ask for help to heal it.